Machiavelli, he states that it's better to be considered good than cruel, but that cruelty often serves as a better weapon. Fear is a stronger bond than loyalty, since you control fear, not love. Operating an organization with like 1980 shops in 50 different markets, it requires a strong organizational structure with efficient communication channels. How do you secure stability? Do you prefer to be loved or feared by your employees?
This, you know, just listening to that Machiavellian quote is enough to make me sick, because it's that thinking that pervades every institution. Or you think of the military institution, you think of, and that's getting less, let me tell you, in the Iraqi invasion. There's more challenges there because that was an illegal war. So you see it in the political institutions, you see it in the religious institutions. You see more fear in religious institutions now than you even find the word love or kindness or compassion. And you certainly see it, funnily enough, I thought it would be buried, this notion of fear, in business organizational structure and organizational behavior. But it sort of, after the dot-com boom and bust, it sort of ground itself up again. I think it's horrendous. I think every worker that is being driven by fear should sabotage the workplace. No doubt about it. Whether it's putting bloody water in the CEO's car, you know, tank, I'd do anything to sabotage it. We in our company sabotaged ourselves because we found I was the oldest member of my community. When we were getting successful in my 40s and everybody was in their 20s. So I've tried to find ways to get them, you know, to challenge me. So when they had their employment manual, there were 6 red envelopes in the employment manual that said, this is what you should do, this is what you can't do, this is what the body shops stand for. There were 6 envelopes, and any time that they were angry about anything that they saw or any bullying or any patriarchal control, they would write to me or the board, and within 24 hours we saw them. So this really cut down bullying. It's cut down the hierarchy of organizational structure, which works a lot in manufacturing plants. We had a notion of making the place a warmer place. So we had a child development center attached to the workplace, the first in England, where 60 kids aren't from 5 months to 5 years. That humanizes the workplace. We had action stations. Every body shop employee was told to do community service. That was that's what they were paid to do. Go out once a week into the community, half a day, and give your time to the community. Volunteering. Thousands and thousands of body shop employees went to Bosnia, went to Balkan states, Albania, Romania, and worked in epicenters of struggle after war. That's what leadership is about, has a moral context. I don't think you get anywhere by fear. And I hate the notion that because you can be cruel, you're validated by that. And it's a lie, absolute lie, that you can say kill people for the greater good. Bullshit. It's just an excuse to be, I think, criminal in your thinking. It's appalling. So I would tear that page up in Machiavellian. I don't believe that at all. And and so says a man who is in control of a state or a community. So says a man who's got the army on his side or the police and forces on his side. That's the language of dictators. That's the language of not benign dictators, but evil dictators. That's the language that would have been better in the mouth of Hitler. So, I don't believe it. In a nutshell.